Welcome everyone to this latest episode of Jim and Java. I'm Jim Dempsey, your host. Well, it's hard to believe that we are moving towards the end of the year. Here we are. We are in the month of November already, and it's just unbelievable to be thinking that Thanksgiving will soon be upon us, as will year end. I hope that you are engaging already in a plan to challenge your partners, especially your critical few at year end, because this is such an important time of the year. And I've produced a number of videos that you can watch. I put out videos on year-end giving. We are covering a wide variety of topics, everything from challenging individuals specifically to year-end commitments. We're also talking a lot about estate design, plan giving. Don't forget about the CARES Act. If you did not see the video on the CARES Act, which is such an important topic this time of the year, please click the link above for that. I've also got other fundraising videos out there that will deal with the area of planned giving as well too. We've got a couple exciting broadcasts coming out specifically about donor advised funds, and also having to do with creative ways to challenge people to asset giving. And if you don't know the difference between asset giving and cash giving, you're going to want to watch those videos that will be coming up in the days and the weeks ahead. So anyway, I appreciate so much each and every one of you. Appreciate this community of individuals who are trying to strive to increase income and become fully funded. So let's dive right in today to our first question for the day. Our question today is from Pete in Richardson, Texas. And Pete asks, are donors or partners really interested in knowing how their money is spent? Well, interestingly enough, Pete, there's probably a yes and a no answer to that. From the standpoint of effectiveness, the answer to that would definitely be yes. I believe that so many of our donors and our partners are interested in knowing how their money is spent, and they really do see it either from the standpoint of a good investment to give to our organization, or in some cases, especially with faith-based organizations and individuals, donors of faith, they really see it as being good stewardship, good stewards. They want to be good stewards of their resources, and they want to give to an organization who is also good stewards of their resources. So from the standpoint of, are they interested in knowing where the money goes and how it's used? Absolutely. And I would also say that even if a partner, and this is kind of where my no side of things, in that they aren't interested, even if our partners didn't give any indication to us that they were really that interested, in other words, if they gave the money either because they trusted us or because they knew who we were and we have a good reputation, I really believe that if you want to maintain and keep a partner for life, which I believe it should be your goal, is to have lifetime giving from someone, I believe that it's going to be critical for you to report back. Because 5, 10, 15, 20 years of giving to an organization without any report back, I don't think that happens very often. And frankly, I don't think it would be wise for you as an individual or you as an organization to not report back on how you're spending their dollars. Now, I don't mean get down to the paperclip and pen that you purchase with that, but the bigger thing that they're interested in is the results. There's a principle that I've said numerous times that I learned early on in my career, which was people give to people justified by the cause. And what I mean by that is that people do want to give to a person. And to be able to name a person, it doesn't have to be the full name, especially if you're an organization that confidentiality is very important for the people that you serve. You can give a first name, or you can give a pseudonym that you use. We're going to refer to this person as, but connecting that person with a face. And again, if your organization is sensitive to confidentiality, there are ways of blocking out a person's face across the top, whether if you're in a sensitive country or serving in an area such as human trafficking, where there is some risk, even a high risk, of the security of the person that you're helping. You can still connect the name and a face and how that person's life was changed. And so knowing how that money is used is so important. And I understand it is very difficult. I work for and a part of an extremely large organization, $500 million organization. And it's difficult for us to track a gift all the way down to the penny for how it was used. We know exactly where the money is going, but to get all the way down to the exact penny out in the field, everything that was spent with that, it's not easy at all. We try and continue to try as hard as we can to do that. But I believe the thing that's most important is not how many pens and how many paper clips we spent with that dollar, but really how many lives were changed and who were some of those lives that were changed as a result of that. So on one hand, I believe that it is very, very important for our partners to know how the money is used. I also believe there's a lot of partners who give us money because they trust us and they believe in us, in what we're doing. I shared in the last couple of videos a very, very interesting statistic that I'd love to share with you right now. Here's that stat. 2/3 of people who make donations do no research before giving. And so what that says to me is that there is a level of trust in a nonprofit organization, and oftentimes people don't do a lot of homework on how that money is going to be used or how it was used. But I believe we have an obligation to report back and let people know. If you are interested in just getting a single gift and no other gift from an individual, which I oftentimes believe is really fundraising itself, because just getting the funds is really your primary focus or concern. But if you are interested in building long-time partners, individuals who are going to be with you for a lifetime, you have got to report back on your findings, your statistics, and report back on the impact that your organization is making and how that money helped you make a difference. So anyway, Pete, I hope that helped answer your question. I just appreciate each question we get. Certainly, if you've got future questions for me, go out to Twitter at DevFStrats and use the hashtag JimAndJava. And certainly, if you want to reach me on Instagram, you can do so at DevEffectivenessStrategies. Just IM me there. Or if you want to send an email to me, you can do so at DevelopmentEffectivenessM@gmail.com. And I wish you the best, of course, as you're moving towards your end, your strategy and everything you do. I want to be out there. We want to be out there for you and to help you. We're a community. We're working together and we're striving to increase income and reach the goal of becoming fully funded. Thanks a lot. We'll see you again next week.